What do you mean by acid? Acid is, we have different concepts. You know, Arrhenius concept, Bronsted-Lowry concept, then Lewis concept. Yeah. So, moonu peru, moonu vidhamana definitions. What is Arrhenius concept? Arrhenius concept enna nyama irukko? According to Arrhenius, acid is any substance that liberate H plus ions into aqueous solution. H plus ion into aqueous solution. What do you mean by aqueous? H plus in water. Okay. The substance which releases H plus ion to aqueous solution is said to be as an acid. And the substances which liberates OH minus ion is said to be as bases. This is the basic concept given by Arrhenius. Okay. Then the second concept is given by Bronsted and Lowry. Are you remembering the concept of Bronsted and Lowry? He made some small difference in Arrhenius concept, and he stated acid as any substance that gives H plus ion. He didn't mention the word aqueous. Yeah, any substance that releases H plus ion in suitable solvent is said to be as an acid. And the substance which can take up the H plus ion is said to be as base. Yeah, Munnadi Arrhenius, he gave the concept OH minus, the word hydroxyl ion, to bases. But here, Bronsted and Lowry, they are stating the substance capable of accepting H plus ion as base. So, the substance which release H plus ion is said to be as acid. And the substance which can accept the H plus ion is said to be as base. Are you clear with this? Okay, so accordingly, suppose you are taking some acid. For example, you take acetic acid. Acetic acid, what is acetic acid? COOH. Suppose you are dissolving it in water, what will happen? CH3, COO minus ion plus H plus ion. Right? So, yes or no? Suppose you are dissolving HCl in water. So, what is the product obtained? You get is H3O plus plus Cl minus. Right? So, you just see in the first case, I will come to the Bronsted and Lowry concept afterwards. Before that, we must discuss about these arrow marks. So, here it is forward arrow, but here it is equilibrium symbol. What it indicates? So, in this case, the HCl dissolved in water is completely converted into Cl minus ion and H3O plus ion. What is H3O plus ion? Hydronium ion. It is said to be as hydronium ion, like ammonium ion. Ammonium means NH3 plus, NH4 plus. So, it is hydronium ion. Okay. So, here it is completely dissociated to give H3O plus plus Cl minus ion. Whereas, in this case, it will undergo only partial dissociation. There is always an equilibrium between the undissociated acetic acid molecule and acetate ions. Are you getting my point? So, why this happens? That is explained by strong and weak acid concepts. Okay? A substance is said to be strong. An acid is said to be strong if suppose it undergoes complete dissociation. Okay? So, the water la pota unna, it will undergo dissociation to give a positively charged species and immediately a negatively charged. Whereas, this will undergo only feeble dissociation. So, the substance which will undergo complete dissociation is said to be as, strong electrolyte. And the substance which will undergo only partial dissociation is said to be as weak electrolytes. Okay. So, example for strong electrolytes, can you state anything, something? Strong electrolytes, example, HCl strong electrolytes all along. Okay. So, suppose you are taking KCl. KCl, what is KCl? Potassium chloride. It is also strong electrolyte. Immediately, suppose you are dissolving it in water, it will give K plus plus Cl minus ions. Okay. So, suppose you are taking NaCl. It is also a strong electrolyte. It will give Na plus plus Cl minus ions. So, these are all said to be as a strong electrolyte, like sulfuric acid, nitric acid. They all are strong electrolytes. So, weak electrolytes, acetic acid, we can say, oxalic acid, acetic acid, succinic acid. Okay, in the case of bases, ammonium hydroxide, ammonium carbonate, these are all said to be as weak bases. Okay, so whereas weak strong bases, we can say sodium hydroxide. Sodium hydroxide, it will immediately give Na plus and OH minus ion. So that's why we are giving give symbol, that is this symbol in the case of strong substances, strong electrolytes, and the reversible symbol in the case of weak electrolytes. Okay, so according to Bronsted and Lowry, okay, the substance which will give H plus ion is said to be as an acid. So this is liberating the H plus ion. Clear? So we can consider this as acid. Okay, so this is accepting, I mean here you have to write it as H3O plus. Okay, water is taking one proton and is converted into H3O plus, protonium ion, hydronium ion we can say. Okay, so here it is accepting, so we can say this as base, isn't it? This is base, right? Okay, so this is again accepting, isn't it? So this is also base. In the reverse reaction, H3O plus will supply H plus ion to acetate ion and is converted into acetic acid. So it is supplying, so we can say it as acid. Are you clear with this? The forward reaction, acetic acid is supplying a H plus ion to H2O, and hence acetic acid is said to be as acid and H2O is said to be as base. In the reverse reaction, H3O plus hydronium ion is supplying a H plus ion to acetate ion, and hence H3O plus is said to be as acid. This is acetate ion is accepting a proton, so it is said to be as base. Okay, so from this acid 1 we are getting base 1, from acid 2 we are getting base 2. Are you getting it? So this is Bronsted and Lowry concept. Are you clear with this? Okay, so the next concept is, so this acid 1 and base 1 is said to be as conjugate acid base pair. Conjugate acid base pair, particularly it is said to be a conjugate acid base pair. Okay, so this is the concept given by, I mean, Bronsted and Lowry. What about Lewis? Lewis concept, so Lewis, he gave electronic concept. Okay, so based on the release of electrons, he defined acid. So acid is any substance that accept or release electrons. That accepts the electron is said to be as acid. Proton kapadiya just opposite. Proton release panichna acid. Okay, according to Lowry, the substance which is capable of accepting electrons are said to be as acids, and the substance which are capable of losing electrons are said to be as bases. Right? Are you clear? So this is Lewis' concept. In most of the cases, we are using the Bronsted and Lowry concept to define an acid. Lewis' concept, the electronic structure based living, we are using in somewhat less. Okay, are you clear with this? Right, so acid. In the case of weak electrolyte, I have told you acetic acid is weak electrolyte. Okay, then he Ostwald relation to this, Ostwald's dilution law. What is Ostwald's dilution law? Yes. Dissociation con, you give the mathematical representation, that is enough, because we need only, yes, so just you take this, otherwise some acid will we use it to calculate K value. K value enga calculate panuva, suppose the reaction is equilibrium reaction, this reaction is said to be as equilibrium reaction. Okay, so K is equal to alpha square C alpha square by 1 minus alpha. So very good. This is said to be as Ostwald's dilution law. Okay. So what is this alpha called? This, this is said to be as dissociation constant. We use it to state it as K. Yes, very good. Alpha is degree of dissociation. What it means? In the case of strong electrolytes like HCl, NaCl, KCl, etc., all the molecules will undergo dissociation. That is, it undergoes 100% dissociation. Okay, suppose you are dissolving 100 HCl molecule into water, it will give 100 H plus ion and 100 Cl minus ion, likewise KCl, NaCl, etc. Whereas in the case of acetic acid, it will undergo only feeble ionization, and there is always an equilibrium between undissociated acetic acid molecule and acetate ions. Okay, so in the case of equilibrium reaction only, we can apply Ostwald's dilution law. So, Ostwald's dilution law is applicable only to weak electrolytes, not to strong electrolytes. So, for equilibrium reaction, we can write equilibrium constant. So, suppose you take a reaction, equilibrium reaction, A plus B gives C plus D, will write equilibrium constant is directly proportional to concentration of the products divided by concentration of the reactants. The same concept we are following here also. Based on that, for weak acid we can say the equilibrium constant. Instead of equilibrium constant, here we are stating it as dissociation constant. Okay, because it is based, I mean dissociation based, ionization based. So we are stating it as dissociation constant. Okay, Ka is equal to C alpha. Alpha is said to be as degree of dissociation. In the case of acetic acid, not all 100 molecules are getting ionized or dissociated. Only a partial. Otherwise, we can say the degree of dissociation is always a fraction. Okay, it is always less than 1. 100 molecules editing up, only 50 molecules will undergo dissociation, and hence what is this fraction? It is nothing but 1 by 2. Okay, so we used to state in terms of percentage. 50% dissociated, 90% dissociated, and the marisol. That means 50 by 100, 90 by 100. Are you clear with this? Okay, so this is Ostwald's dilution law. So Ostwald's dilution law is applicable only to weak electrolytes and not to strong electrolytes. Okay.